Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, we like to end the official broadcast week with a bang, and we'll certainly be doing that today. I'm Alex Jones, your host. Thank you for joining us. We're blasting out on the GCN Radio Network, GCNLive.com. We're going to have pharmacist Ben Fuchs in studio with us in the second hour, talking about Big Pharma, Monsanto, and ways to reverse all of the designed poisoning from the aspartame and the bisphenol A and the MSG and all the rest of it. He'll be in studio with us. And then we're going to have our once-a-week financial discussion and phone calls with Bob Chapman of the International Forecaster. And in studio, who's also down here in town with Ben Fuchs, the one, the only, Ted Anderson, who looks about 20 years younger and has lost, it's more than 30 pounds. I mean, I saw him a few months ago and he lost a bunch of weight on longevity. It's not even designed to make you lose weight. Just when you get the nutrition you need, you stop eating as much. I've lost 37 pounds, as you know, in 2 months. And Dr. Corey Gold's here also at the studio. I may bring him in here. He's the inventor of Pollen Burst, one of my favorite longevity products, also available at InfoWarsTeam.com. But separate from that, wow, we love fighting the globalists. We love winning. We love having 15 million listeners between XM, over 100 AM and FM affiliates, Global Shortwave, WWCR, number one podcast and audio streams at InfoWars.com, and growing exponentially. But a big part of that is obviously you, the listener, spreading the word. That's the bedrock backbone. But the Drudge Report drives more traffic than the New York Times, Twitter, and Facebook combined. And there's only one link on the internet that is number one. It is the top super juicy, as we call it here in the office. I think we've only had that six or seven times. We've got the big, giant, humongoid link at drudgereport.com right now. And sure, click on that big, giant white whale. Look at it. TSA trains Super Bowl hot dog sellers to spot terrorists. I mean, but yeah, they've got the guys that come around going, hot dogs, got you hot dogs and peanuts. And they're like looking for spies everywhere. About 4 or 5 years ago, I was actually at the Austin Bergstrom Airport about to fly out on a story. And Aaron Dykes goes, hey, Alex, look at that. And we're sitting there eating some barbecue at the Salt Lick there at the airport. And I look over. And there's a TSA agent looking side to side like they're James Bond fantasizing. And they had a black book. It was a black covered book with white text on it. And Aaron remembers the exact name. It was something like how someone becomes a terrorist. And subtext, how you catch them before they know they're one. I mean, they give these guys a couple hour course. Last time I flew out of Austin, they did this questionnaire thing where... Well, they call it a chat down. You get your chat down, you take your shoes off, your belt off, you get a body scan, and most people I've seen body scanned. So every time I fly, I'll sit on the other side after I've gone through the checkpoint and refuse the scan, and I'll watch them, and most people are groped. And let me tell you, if you see a woman who everybody's whistling at, oh, she's getting groped. In fact, they admit now with Senator Rand Paul that they hit a button to screen him after he agreed to go through the scanner. He agreed to go through the microwave oven, and then Dr. Paul said, I don't know. Oh, you said there's something on my leg? No, no. I pulled up his pants, and they said, look, we're going to grab your genitals. And he said, no, you're not. I'm going to go back through the scanner. And they said, well, you're not going to leave here. Then they held him for an hour and a half and got caught lying and said he got irate. But now they admit that that it alerted for a random search. That happened last time I flew out of Austin. I went through, it wasn't the sound of metal, it was like a beep, and he goes, oh, you've been chosen for a random grope. And I said, no, you're not going to grope me. And they said, fine, just stand over in this box so we can make you feel guilty that you're a criminal. I mean, that's a psychological warfare operation. All right, it's a giant transmission. I haven't even scratched the surface. All the big headlines straight ahead. Stay with us, InfoWars.com. It is Friday, the third day of February. 2012. We're going to be live here for the next 3 hours, and I'll be back this evening with the nightly news, 7 o'clock Central, 8 o'clock Eastern, obviously, 5 o'clock Pacific, 6 o'clock Mountain. And we, of course, will be back this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central, with the Sunday abbreviated transmission as well, because there's so much news. We don't take a long weekend around here. I'll be live this Sunday. Okay, where to begin? TSA trains Super Bowl hot dog sellers to spot terrorists. And they're training school teachers to spot, and they're training gun dealers and barber shops. We've shown you the training manuals that barbers and auto mechanics and swap meet organizers are given by the FBI. And they say if someone's wearing jeans or has a cell phone or has a camera, oh, that's the big one. If someone has a camera, or if the police pull you over and you have a snorkel and mask, heaven forbid, that means you must want to blow up a dam, because that happens so often, because there's so many terrorists. Of course, if they attack Iran, Iran might actually fight back. And that's some of the headlines today. The defense secretary is quoted in the Washington Post and their publications as saying Israel is set to attack, according to the secretary of defense. I don't know if this is true. Iran in April. And Iran has been told not to defend themselves, or it is going to be the greatest evil, the most outrageous thing ever seen. And if Iran as much as lifts an arm to block those bunker-busting missiles coming in, it will be called the biggest outrage on Earth. They'll be hyperventilating on the news, screaming, pulling out of hair. Oh, my God, Iran actually defended themselves, because everybody knows. I'm not being sarcastic here. This is actually being said. A couple months ago, they were beating people in an Occupy event, and the cops charged the people with resisting for balling up. So now balling up is resisting. And I guess if Iran, I guess if a giant missile was coming and you balled up, they'd be on the news and say, when they knew the missile was coming, they balled up. Oh, my God. Oh, oh, kill them all. Glass parking lot them. But and by the way, that five-year-old was running in the playground. Arrest them. Oh, that's Associated Press. It's an insane, sick society that we now live in. So we have that report. TSA trains Super Bowl hot dog sellers to spot terrorist. Viper search teams should be out in force before Sunday's game. The TSA has trained the gropers that'll be groping you and your wife and children if you're dumb enough to go to this game and put up with all the garbage. We're going to be breaking all of that down. Also, we're going to continue with our coverage of the latest developments on Fast and Furious, where the mafia government has been caught perjuring themselves before Congress, where they have been in contempt, and where they will not release any of the documents. Now, some of the documents have been leaked to CBS News and others, and yes, it was a plan to blame the Second Amendment. A plan to blame the Second Amendment. And if you're a new listener, just type into the search engine. Documents reveal ATF wanted to blame Fast and Furious on the Second Amendment. And it was a plan to try to take your liberties and destabilize Mexico, but also fund and arm certain drug cartels like Sinaloa that were waging war against other cartels that were not laundering their money through the proper U.S. banks, which Bloomberg also reports in just the last 2 years laundered $376 billion, just Wachovia and Wells Fargo alone. You know, Wells Fargo, the good little guy, Warren Buffett, who shut down the big oil pipeline coming into the U.S. from Canada so his trains can carry it to the west coast of Canada to China. Again, Bloomberg and AP reported. The nice little man that says, raise taxes on the rich. He means middle class, so he can be given it in banker bailout money, as he has been. Because he became this big billionaire, because he's such a loving person. And he gives the money to Planned Parenthood, who's under criminal investigation, of course, and who's gets taxpayer money in Travis County, where I live, to pay for the abortions, and who sucks all this government money, and who on record is a eugenics outfit. Even if you're for abortion, Understand, Margaret Sanger, Planned Parenthood, got awards from Adolf Hitler, and they gave him awards. And they said, we were established to kill black people because they're subhuman. And, of course, there were, according to Planned Parenthood, there are, of course, with the big scandal 3 years ago where grants were given to Planned Parenthood and they accepted to make sure it went to abort black babies. They're like, I just want this money in the tape conversations to go to getting the black babies. And they're like, oh, we understand. Oh, yes, you can pull those up. Because, again, real fascist eugenicist don't run up in a Nazi uniform and say Sieg Heil. That's usually some federal operative, you know, trying to pass some hate law. They've been caught dressing up like Nazis for media consumption. The feds have been caught and others have on record. Just type in Nazi rally in Orlando run by feds. Nazi rally in New York run by feds. Nazi rally in Houston run by feds. Nazi rally in Salt Lake run by fed. I mean, you'll get Orlando Sentinel, Salt Lake City Tribune. Look it up. The real Nazis have got long hair and sandals, and they mix in with the regular hippies and people that are actually against racism. And they're like, women choice, trendy, And they've got that NPR voice. They've learned how to get the job done. In fact, later I'm going to get to this stack of news, and I have some audio clips putting it all in perspective. But the Daily Caller reports, after cutting ties with Planned Parenthood, the Komen donations up 100%, which basically means they doubled. And they cut it saying, we're only concerned with breast cancer and there's too much controversy with Planned Parenthood. And they're under criminal investigation, so we're not going to fund them. Now, I thought I'd give you some background. We have a video clip later on this. Pelosi, Girl Scouts, relationship with Planned Parenthood, very valuable. Yeah, they teach women it's their right and sacrament to not have a man in the house and to have abortions. And again, even if you love your abortion and think it's a special goodie you have, the point is, this is all about eugenics. And then, of course, I have another clip that we'll get to later if we have, or you can just type in Pelosi and population control. And you can find her. One of the interviews was on Meet the Press. Another was with CNS News. But here's a quote. Contraception will reduce cost to the states and to the federal government. And then she goes on, population reduction is needed to balance the budget. Remember that 3 years ago? Now, let me just give you a background here. We've shown you actuaries, gone over the numbers that even insurance companies have put out. This is no secret that the baby boomers, they're going to be less people born to baby boomers. Baby boomers, on average, one male, one female baby boomer, on average, together, both of them together, replicate 1.3 in the United States. Same number in Canada, even lower in Europe. The only reason our population has gone up is the immigrant influx, 50 plus million in the last 40 years or so. Okay? We'd be like Russia with an imploding population if there wasn't a giant immigrant flood. Okay? So, Pat Buchanan wrote a book on it, Death of the West. It's a mathematical fact. Japan's got 1.2. Italy's got 1.2. So, for two people, they have on average 1.2.